Pedro, my presentation is the toughness evolution of Linus satellite tungsten alloy. This is my co-work. Linus laser relativity satellite is a passive satellite. It was launched on February 13, 2012, using the new European Space Agency's laser Vega to measure with height accuracy the effect of the Earth angular momentum on the space-time geometry that in turn affect the orbit motion of a satellite. This effect is called the frame tracking or lens steering effect. Linus is a massive sphere of tungsten alloy covered with 92 cube corner reflectors. Of concern with the topic of this presentation is the CCR mounting system, each one constituted by two plastic rings in a tungsten alloy retainer ring and three tungsten screws. The Linus 2 mission has been recently proposed aiming to the construction and launch of a second Linus satellite, which in one possible configuration has a larger diameter and mass. During Laser 1 manufacturing, some issues related to the low fracture toughness of tungsten alloy were evident. The most critical part being the screw used for anchoring CCR. This is a feature with this problem. All these components are critical during the satellite launch when they are subject to high levels of acceleration and vibration. On the basis of all this consideration, it is of paramount importance to measure the fracture toughness of this material in order to evaluate in a second stage feasible thermomechanical treatments that should be able to increase safety margins. This is necessary because all the satellite metallic components have to be made of the same alloy. In the study, metallographic structure of alloy specimen were inspected by optical SEM ADS microscope. A set of specimens were made in accordance with ISTM standard E399, means of electrodischarge machine. ISTM E399 involves in the testing of notched specimen either in tension or three-point bending. the dimension of the specimen is reported. Fracture surface and the crack propagation were analyzed by SEM. Tungstenite alloy produced by liquid sintering are characterized by tungstenite particles surrounded by a binder. The tungstenite alloy used for LARES program is constituted by tungstenite grains in a continuous nickel-copper matrix. In liquid phase sintering of the alloy used for LARES, a mixture of tungstenite and nickel-copper powder is heated at about 1500 degrees centigrade at atmospheric pressure. The alloy cool down within the furnace with some circulated nitrogen. The alloy densification is reached mostly by rearrangement of tungstenite particle that grow due to tungstenite transport throughout the liquid. The interparticle bonding affect mainly mechanical properties such as strength and ductility. The tungstenite alloy is characterized by tungstenite grain embedded in a matrix that was liquid at the sintering temperature. The DS analysis carried out in the studied alloy showed that the particles are pure tungstenite, while the binder phase containing nickel, copper, tungsten, iron. The main composition of the alloy is 92% tungsten, 6% nickel, and 2% copper. Fracture toughness test gave the load deflection curve reported in figure, while the kappa q calculated values are reported in the tables. The we have put KQ. The acceptance criteria is important. The ratio P max PK PQ for specimen 1, 2, and 4 is slightly higher than 1.10, while the values of the thickness criteria is verified. Considering that specimen 3 KQ is equal to K1C and that KQ values are very similar, it can be assumed that the toughness is 12 megapascal meter square root is the fracture toughness of this study alloy. The crack grow with a mixed mod that is initially intergranular and then partially transgranular with cleavage fracture throughout the tungsten grain. This is due to the possible compression of the grain by the matrix phase. This is another picture. There are the transgranular and the intergranular part. In conclusion, test results give values of fracture toughness extremely repetitive. The mean values is 12 megapascal meter square root. These values are quite close to this those available in literature on similar tungsten alloy. We have to find more data about this kind of the alloy. Although the values obtained in the test presented here are slightly higher. On the basis of our results, it will be possible to study feasible thermomechanical treatment aimed at increasing the alloy toughness, as already suggested by literature data for similar alloys. Thank you.